Okay, welcome once again to Samike Math and Mathematics. What we want to discuss today is very interesting, and that is what we call homomorphism. Let me bring it down. We've been talking about groups and we've been talking about subgroups, but can there be a relationship between a group and another group? Can there be a structural similarity between two groups where I am adding something in this other group and I'm multiplying in this other group, and it looks as if the structure of the two groups are similar? That is what we want to check today, the structural similarities of two groups. What do I mean by homomorphism? By homomorphism, I mean if we have two groups, let me say G with this binary operation star, and I have another, let me say H with another binary operation, let me say O, as a binary operation here. What we mean by homomorphism is that if we map, remember I talked about mapping in one of my videos, G to H. Now, for A, B, two elements, two arbitrary elements in G, we must find out that F of A connected by this binary operation is the same thing as F of A connected by the other binary operation. So you see, this is the binary operation that connects the two elements here, and this is the binary operation that connects the two elements here. Remember that F of A is the image of A in G. Take note, that is very, very important. So if I'm doing this with this binary operation, is this going to be happening with their images? I am doing this with the range. Is this going to be happening with their images? That is what we talk about in homomorphism. Now, just like mapping, homomorphism can be one-to-one. It can be onto. It can be one-to-one where you have one element mapped to one element uniquely, and it can be onto where the whole element will map to a single element. So I'll have something like this is my G, this is my H, this is my H. So I have A, I have B, here I have F of A, and here I have F of B. So by one-to-one, you have something of this nature. So but this one is a very clear example. This is F of A, this is what F of B, this is one-to-one, and this is also onto, because all the elements here are mapped. So if I was to have, maybe, let me see, C here, and this maps to this also, this is still a function, but in this case, it's still a mapping, but in this case, it is not one-to-one, but it is onto. Homomorphism. But the truth is that when we have something of this nature, where it is one-to-one, and whereby you can also have an inverse mapping, so this mapping we can call it. So F is the homomorphism, and it is order preserving. It is operation preserving. What do I mean? Operation preserving is what you see here. So here you are using this operation, using the homomorphism. Here you are using this other operation. There is nothing wrong with the operation you are using here, and the operation you are using here is still intact. So we say it is operation preserving. So you see, in this case, is that it maps an element here, this to this, and maps this to this. Again, we continue this. It maps the identity here to F of E here, which will be the identity element. So it maps the identity element of this group to the identity element of this group. And again, it maps AB. So if you are having AB here, if AB was with respect to this operation, so I'm going to put star here, and this is related to this operation, so it is going to map this to, I need some space, it's going to map the, it's going to map this to F of A circle F of B.
So it's very good that you note all this. So by looking at this diagram, you know all that. It seems to map the inverse of this also. So if it is A inverse of this, it's going to map this to F inverse of A. So that is F A inverse. F of A all inverse. So you see, this is what happens. So it is operation preserving, it is order preserving. Now let us go, we'll be talking about homomorphism. And whenever we have a homomorphism that is onto and it is one to one at the same time, we talk about and the inverse, that is you have F inverse of F, the same thing as F of F inverse of any element giving you the identity, then we say that this is an isomorphism. So an isomorphism is a bijective homomorphism. Note that statement, you can see it written there. Whole isomorphism is a bijective homomorphism. Whenever homomorphism is bijective, that is, it is one to one and onto at the same time, then we say that it is an isomorphism. We have monomorphism for one to one, and we have epimorphism and so on, and automorphism. You can read all that, but I just want to explain isomorphism because in most cases we look at that example. Now, I want to take at least two examples to explain what I am doing. So let us look at this example. So the first example is that we are going to take two groups, take note, two groups. The first group is we are going to have an homomorphism that maps the set of positive real numbers with addition, this is a group, and maps this to, let us just say, the set of positive real numbers with multiplication. This is a group, I hope you know that they are a group. There are two groups. So we want to take an example here. The example we want to take here is this function. We want to take a function f of x equals to 2 raised to the power of x. So what I want to show is this an isomorphism. What is it an isomorphism? Let us prove that. Now we know that the order here is that we should add. So let us see. If we are to add two elements a plus b in this place, what is going to happen? We are going to have 2 with respect to this, 2 raised to the power of a plus b. And you know by indices, this is the same thing as 2 raised to the power of a times 2 raised to the power of b. And take note that this is actually, following this, is actually f of a, and this is actually f of b. Now can you see that I am adding a plus b in this group, and boom, what I'm having here is that I am multiplying their images with respect to the multiplication that is here in this group. I give you another example again, a very suitable example. Let's move over here. So, it shows that is an isomorphism. Sorry, I didn't tell you that. So that is an isomorphism. So I give you another example, and that example is the log function. So I'm still going to use the same, I'm not going to use the same map this time. I'm going to use the reverse this time. So let's call this a log function. We are going to map r plus with multiplication. We want to map this to r plus with addition. So we want to see, is this a group? Now, an example of this is a log function. A log function. Log x probably equals to y. Now, let us see. Here we have multiplication. So here we are going to have log. We are going to pick two elements here, A and B. So this is going to give us log AB. And we know that in mathematics that log AB is the same thing as log A plus log B by rules of logarithm. And we know very well that this is the same thing, according to this, this is the same thing as log A will simply give us another element, probably B. Remember that this is onto. Let me not use B this time. Let me use X equals to Y. Let's use A, B. A equals to, let's say C, for instance. And this is going to give us another element. Let me say K. Just any C and K being in R plus. So, beautiful. We are multiplying this. Remember this A times B. At the end of the day, we are having what? Addition. Addition is the operation on this group. Multiplication is the operation on this group. I give one more example before we call it a day, and it's a very interesting example, and that one is also an isomorphism. So let us see that. That is a mapping of F taken this set of complex positive complex number with addition. With addition, this is actually a group. I'm mapping this to the set of It is called the unit circle. Why do we call it the unit circle? Remember, the S1 is the same thing as Z, such that the absolute value of Z is equals to 1, where Z is equals to R, E, I, theta. So the function we want to pick here is F of R, E, I, theta. Is theta is okay, but it's theta giving us E, I, theta. So this is the mapping I am taking from here. We're going to take two elements from here. Remember that the binary operation here is multiplication. The binary operation here is multiplication with the unit circle and this condition, E, I, theta, where R in this case is equal to 1, which is the radius of the circle. Now, what we are going to do here is very simple. So we are going to put our theta as alpha plus beta and see what we are going to have. So here we are going to have F of R, E, I, then alpha plus beta. You see that at the end of the day, that is going to give us F of R, E, I, alpha, times E, I, beta. Of the time. And do that. That's very simple and direct. And you remember by this definition, this is supposed to be E I alpha E I beta. So remember that is supposed to be what we have. And you can see that this is simply F of R E I alpha times F of R by this definition, R E I beta. So you see that here I'm using the binary operation addition on the set of positive complex number. And what am I arriving at? I'm multiplying their images. This is actually the images. So you see here what I'm having is a multiple of their images. So you see, that is what happened. So this is a very beautiful example of an isomorphism. Why is that an isomorphism? Because it's one-to-one and it's also onto. You can see it clearly, it is onto, and you can see that it's also one-to-one. Beautiful concept. You see at the end of the day, the binary operation, the operation here is preserved, and the operation here is preserved. There are so many examples, many more examples, but I just wanted to use a few examples to illustrate homomorphism mapping between one group to another. The next concept I'll be talking about is normal subgroup. Before I do that, I'm going to go back to discuss integrals. Some students have been saying I should discuss integrals. So the next series I'll be talking about from Thursday will be integrals. Thank you for being a part of Modern Algebra. Subscribe and remember to sponsor. Bye.